My name is Taylor Swift. I'm 16 years old, and I want to be a country music recording artist. I'm alone on my own,
and that's all. In this last year, everything I've ever worked for has started to pay off. This is my story. Oh, I'm just a girl.
This last year has been absolutely amazing, and I mean, it's like everything I've ever wanted, everything I've been working for all this time is just happening. Because getting a record deal means being able to do what I want to do.
I signed Taylor Swift to Big Machine Records because I had to.
I was the first artist that he talked to about his new label, and I sat down and met him, and I played him some songs live. And there was just this instant connection.
I was just smitten on the spot. It was like a lightning bolt.
The best part about getting a record deal was that it wasn't just a record deal, it was the right deal for me. I'm just so grateful that I got the right one and that I'm with people that I believe in and that they believe in me.
I couldn't get up in the morning and not have her as part of this label.
This is my chance. This is my chance to bring my music out of my bedroom where I'm writing it. Oh, I'm just a girl.
I think it's definitely very surreal right now because there are so many firsts, so many amazing firsts that have happened lately. One of them was definitely playing on the Opry for the first time. That was like an unbelievable moment.
Congratulations on your Grand Ole Opry debut. Love Mom and Dad.
Oh, it's
here.
That's cute.
Thank you.
As I'm walking out there, there's this circle in the middle of the stage. Dun, dun, dun. It's like everybody from Patsy Cline to Keith Urban to Leanne Rimes to, well, me now, have stood on that circle.
Not believe I'm about to play here.
And it's just like you walk across there and I'm just like, well,
wow.
Well, this is really happening.
You think happiness, I hope you think that little black dress. Think of my head on your chest and my old faded blue jeans. When you think to my girl, I hope you think of me.
The ACMs was basically the first time that I did a real red carpet event and walked out, and there's all these photographers and they're like, Taylor, turn around, over the shoulder, blah, blah. And of course, I'm like vamping it up. I'm like having a blast.
And we are hanging out with the star of GAC's Shortcut, Taylor Swift. First time walking the orange carpet here at the ACMs. Is this whole experience, is it overwhelming for you or what?
So exciting. Everybody looks beautiful. I've just been walking around starry-eyed this whole time, just having a blast. It's amazing.
The first time I heard Tim McGraw on the radio, it was here in Nashville. And I was listening to the radio, and I'm just driving down the road. This girl calls in and is like, hi, can I hear that Tim McGraw song you played earlier? That and he's like, what Tim McGraw song do you want to hear? She's like, the one by Taylor Swift. And I'm like, yes, yes. And so I was like freaking out and I almost drove off the road.
My big dream is to look out into a crowd of thousands of people and have them singing the words to my songs. That to me would just be everything I've ever hoped for.
I think I first realized I wanted to be in country music and be an artist when I was 10. And I started dragging my parents to festivals and fairs and karaoke contests. And I did that for about a year before I came to Nashville for the first time. I was 11 and I had this demo CD of me singing Dixie Chicks and Leanne Rimes songs and walked into every major record label and was like, hey, I'm Taylor, I'm 11, I want a record deal, you know, call me.
So I watched her walk up to the receptionist desk, and how are you going to look at a little blonde-haired, blue-eyed 11-year-old who's trying to make her dream come true and say, you know, get out of here? They didn't. They were sweet to her, and they took her demo, and nothing happens.
I think that was the trip that really made me realize that I needed to be different. So I went back home to Pennsylvania where I grew up and started writing songs and picked up a 12-string guitar and started to play. That's when I started writing every single day after school. I would go into town after school and write until 9 p.m., come home, do my homework, and that's what I did for about 2.5 years straight.
The Outside was a song that I wrote when I was 12 years old, and I was really going through a period of time where I felt very much an outsider. and it was a really a period of adjustment for me. And I spent a lot of time alone, and I spent a lot of time looking at people and watching what they did and really feeling like I was on the outside of things looking in. I want to make people feel things when they hear my music. I want to give a song to someone who's going through a breakup. I want to give a song to someone who loves someone and can't tell them. A song for someone who has just fallen in love. And a song for just people who are living their lives.
Nobody ever tried to be better. Nobody ever lets me in, and I can still see you. This ain't the best view. On the outside, looking in, I've been a lot of lonely places. I've never been on the outside.
Coming up next, Taylor hooks up to a million new fans on the web. And later, she takes her talents into the studio to record her debut CD.
The song A Place in This World, and I was just sort of kind of looking around at all these big buildings and all these important people and wondering how I was going to fit in. I'm 16 years old and I'm a sophomore at Hendersonville High School. And usually when I'm at school, a song will just pop into my head. Sitting there in class and getting a melody and lyrics just coming to you, and you're just like, oh God. And I'll pull out my cell phone and make a voice memo, and people think I'm crazy talking to myself.
Any situation, she can write a song about it, and I've never seen anybody do anything like it.
I feel something, I filter it into a song.
I've seen her pull out a Kleenex and write on it.
But that's how some of my best songs have been written. It's really interesting, yeah, because I have to explain to different writers that I co-write with, well, you know, I can't write at 10 o'clock because I get out of school at 3. My friends are extremely supportive. I hang out with them as much as possible. When I'm not working, I'm with them.
So when are you not working?
They know all the words to my songs. They really just support me as a person and as an artist. They're all just beautiful to me, and I love them.
Her dreams of being a country music artist are very realistic, and she's just so close right now.
I met Abigail freshman year. I walked into first period English class.
I didn't know she was a country music singer. I didn't know any of that. And I remember we were assigned an essay, and I thought mine was good. Some other girls thought theirs was good, and they couldn't wait to read theirs. And then when Taylor wrote hers, we were just blown away.
I hear some, like, country music stars right now that I think she's got a better voice and has more potential than they do.
Just tell me what you think. My friends are such a big part of my life, and
They're the people that I want to like my music because I want people like them around the world to like my music. When I write a new song, I love to play it for my friends, and they're brutally honest.
I think Taylor has gotten to the point to where she comes to the people she's closest to get their opinions, and thinks she knows that if we're gonna like it and accept it, then without a doubt, she's gonna put it out.
When people see someone get up and sing a song about what they're going through, they can identify with it and really like it.
I think seeing that they actually liked the song a lot really encouraged me.
MySpace is an awesome new thing. It's an online website where people can really connect with artists. Every night I really try to keep tabs on my MySpace and see people who are leaving me comments.
Oh.
Typically I get about 600 emails a day. I read all the guest book entries. I want to be a part of these people's lives. I think it's important to keep that personal contact. That's the most fun thing for me, is to hear what people think and all the different stories of people the first time they heard the song, how it affected them. I just love all that. I'm so consumed by it.
They come on and tell their life story or why this song has meant so much to them. And that's where it becomes a real personal thing. They're sharing. They're sharing their lives with Taylor.
I read all of them, but it's hard to answer every single one. But I try really hard.
I'm alone.
All these people are doing this because they're touched by the music, and I could never ask for more than that.
Coming up next, Taylor Swift hits the road for radio, and still ahead, she takes her music live in front of thousands of new fans.
Stars that shine in the sky, the pretty lights.
A big challenge for every new artist is going into the studio for the first time when the red light is on.
I love the recording process because I love singing, and it really gives me a chance to hone in on every single word, make it count, make it perfect. And I'm a perfectionist, and in the case of Nathan Chapman, I met him when I was 14, and he was making our demos in a shack behind the publishing company. And I just fell in love with what he did with my songs.
So what do you think of this mix?
I think it's awesome.
Take me back to the house in the backyard tree. Sanjit beat me up, you were bigger than.
Recording because I've always had a lot to do with it, and you know, my producer Nathan always lets me have so much input on anything I'm singing, anything he's laying down for tracks, and I feel like I've had so much to do with this album. I love it.
Well, Taylor just knows who she is, and she knows what she wants to say with her, the lyrics of her songs and with the music, and she knows who she wants to be, and she knows where she fits in this big thing called the music business.
I'll be 87, you'll be 89. I'll still look at you like the stars that shine in the sky. Oh, my.
It's been amazing. I'm so glad that we've been able to do this music with this person. People around here say that once you get the record deal, that's when the hard part starts. And I'm well aware of that and ready to step up to bat.
97.9 FM, it is a big 98 WSIX 831 on a Friday night.
Radio tour is where you go out and you go and meet with every single radio station in the country.
Well, I told you she would stop by, and now, ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome Big Machine recording artist, it's Taylor Swift! Well, you know, the first thing I noticed about Taylor is that she's, you know, 16 years old, and she has so much to say. Now, we promised the folks we'd take a call or two. You want to take
a
call?
Let's take some calls.
All right, why don't you go ahead and grab line one there.
The Big 98, this is Taylor Swift.
Hey, Taylor. I love your song, Tim McGraw. Oh, my gosh, I love it. The first time I heard it, I was on my way to school, and I just started bawling. I mean, it touched me. It really hit home. It really hit the heart.
Thank you. Oh, my gosh. That means so much to me. Thank you so much.
You're welcome. Have a great night, all right?
You too.
Would you guys like to hear a new song? Yeah?
But I really do try to be a nice person.
Okay.
But. If you break my heart or hurt my feelings or are really mean to me,
yeah.
I'm going to write a song about you.
No.
Oh, yeah.
I don't think you could do it if you weren't a people person.
So watch me strike out. Yeah, John, I'll always be top. As far as I'm concerned, you're just another picture to burn.
Most of the people in radio are really about music. And I love going out and talking to people who are as passionate about music as I am.
Burn.
Very nice. What do you say there?
Thank you. I literally went to high school up until the point where my single was released. Over the summer, I made the decision to go to homeschooling because, you know, it comes to a point where you have to say, okay, I like school, but I love this and I can't miss it.
Homeschooling came about because we knew that the schedule was getting more and more demanding every day.
Basically, I'm on a program where I pretty much do it myself and read a chapter and then do some work.
Whenever we're sitting in the airport, she pulls out her workbooks.
It's really perfect for me because I can do it on planes and I can do it on the bus. I'm trying to do as much work as I can possibly do. I want to get through school. I really do. I want to graduate. I just want to do it really fast. I really miss her. I'm used to running out of my classroom, immediately going to Taylor's locker, or just standing in the middle of the lobby looking for Taylor, and I can't do that anymore. It's hard because, you know, you have a group of friends that they're all doing different things. They're all talking about stuff that I've kind of missed out on during the week.
Even though Taylor's gone and on the road, I know in the back of my head that she's doing what she's always wanted to do, and she's bettering her career and becoming what she's always wanted to be.
Coming up next, the hard work pays off for Taylor when she meets face-to-face with new fans moved by her music. When Taylor Swift, A Place in This World, continues.
Shotgun with my hair undone in the front seat of his car. Got a one hand bail on the steering wheel, the other on my heart.
The CMA Music Fest was amazing. It was so much fun because that was actually the first time that we'd gotten that band together and done the full band show.
And he says, our song is to slam the street door, speaking out loud, tapping on your window when we're on the phone.
When you're live, people can see it on your face, and they can see what the song means to you. I'll never just sing one of my songs with a straight face like it means nothing to me, because I wrote these songs, and they all mean something to me.
Could play it again.
When you can look to the people in the front row who are singing the words to your songs, I love that. I love to be able to look at someone and make that contact and kind of nod your head at them and say, look, thanks. Thank you for being here.
I was riding shotgun with my hair undone in the front seat of his car. I grabbed a pen and an old napkin and I wrote down our song.
Afterward, I try to meet and greet with people as long as I possibly can. It's always been really important to me because I've been that kid standing in that autograph line with my mom.
They just love her because she's just one of them. Taylor is entirely approachable.
We feel like we owe them
an awful lot for being there to support her.
I try not to refer to people who like my music as fans, because I try to refer to them all as my friends. Because, you know, I'm going to try to be a part of their lives just as much as they're being a part of mine.
He said the way my blue eyes shine with those Georgia stars, a shame that night. I said that's a lie.
I wrote the song Tim McGraw. Well, I got the idea for it in math class, and it was my freshman year, and I'm sitting there and I just started singing this hook. I applied the song to what I was going through at the time, and I was dating this guy who was going off to college, and I knew we were going to break up, and, you know, I was thinking about all the things that I knew would remind him of me.
But when you think tomorrow, hope you think my favorite song, when we dance you all night long, you like a spotlight on the
brain. It never really occurred to me that that song would be so relatable.
Hope you think that little light.
It's definitely very surreal because, I mean, my mom and I were sitting there in the car talking the other day and we're just like, this song's in the top 20, isn't it? And I'm like, yeah! And it's just, it's such a moment. I mean, this is such a moment in time that I know is never going to come again. I'm so thankful that all this has happened, and I thought of a million names of people who have helped me get here, people who have stood in line to get my autograph, called and requested my song on the radio, helped me in some way, you know, let me get up on a stage when I was 10 years old. I think, you know, this whole time I've been dreaming of sitting right here and being able to tell you all the things that have happened in the last year and have it be real. It's real.